If you can't do at least one visualization per day, keep watching as I share with you 10 tips on what to do to speed up your workflow inside 3ds Max. Setting up the workspace is one of the first steps you should do before starting working on the projects. Everyone is different. We use software for different purposes. We use different options. Various layouts work better for each of us. And we do some things more than others. For this reason, using the default workspace is most likely not a great idea. Ask yourself the question, what interface of 3ds Max will be the most convenient for me? Think about the options you use the most often. What would you like to see in your main toolbar? How many viewports you typically use? How much space you need for the layer explorer, command panel, etc. After you know the answer, adjust the workspace to your needs. By the way, you can download our checklist that includes all the steps we do to optimize 3ds Max for free from our website. I put the link to it in the corner and in the description below the video. Using shortcuts is a must for me. This is one of the simplest things you can do to speed up your work many times. Let's take an example. The keys from 1 to 5 in editable poly. When I'm using shortcuts, changing between vertices, edges, borders, polygons, and elements is way quicker than doing it with the use of the mouse. It seems to be just a little different, but imagine that you are using this almost constantly during the production process. Changing these small actions make a huge difference in the long run. And this was just the easiest example. There are far more. You can not only use the default hotkeys, but also you can create your own ones. For example, lately I changed my workspace a bit and instead of having a copy and paste script located in my toolbars, I have it now as a shortcut. So I use Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V to copy and paste objects between the scenes on my computer and Shift plus Ctrl plus C and Shift plus Ctrl plus V to copy and paste objects between the scenes on computers that are connected to the network. Using quads is another way of speeding up the production process. Instead of looking for an option, for example, in the main toolbar, you can easily access it just by right-clicking on the mouse. Again, you can use what is default, but why do this if you can adjust it to your needs? For me, for instance, having an interactive rendering option here is a must. But I also use 2D pan zoom mode pretty often in Corona during creating images, so I cannot imagine not having it here as well. Scripts are sort of the magical tools in 3ds Max. Thanks to some codes, they can make quite complicated actions with just one click. For example, the one that I use pretty often and that is super handy is Quick Attach. So instead of adding objects together one by one or looking for objects by name, I can just select objects and attach them with the script. It is a really wise thing to compose your own group of scripts and add them to the main toolbar. You can see that I have the custom toolbar here. If you want to get the full knowledge on how we optimize everything inside 3ds Max, plus all our quads, shortcuts, toolbars with scripts and icons, library structure, layer structure, templates and more, make sure you check out our optimization training that has been freshly updated to 3ds Max 2023 version. You'll find the link to it in the corner and in the description below this video. Using plugins can be another thing that can speed up your work in many ways. For instance, by using the Rare Clone plugin, we can create parametric objects. At the first glance, it sometimes takes longer to create it, but if a client comes back with feedback to change some dimensions in a whole structure, it becomes a piece of cake then. Or Project Manager. I cannot imagine work without it. We can easily access our library, drag and drop the models, link textures, and much more. Without this plugin, handling a scene may be a nightmare. What is even more important, it becomes really time-consuming. In day-to-day life, as well as when working in 3ds Max, automating is key if you want to work fast. The things that you repeat many times should be automated. Why to repeat something all over again if you already did it? The perfect example will be setting up the template file. Instead of setting up the preferences, render engine units, etc., every time you open 3ds Max, you can set it up once and use it every time you open the software. This point is obvious to me. Use Slate Material Editor instead of Compact One. Using the Slate Material Editor is just faster and more clear. You will not have to click so many times as in the Compact Material Editor to get to a desired option. If you want to learn more about this, I created a video dedicated to this topic. The link will be in the description below the video. Setting up the library should be done at the time you downloaded your first model. However, as life goes, I guess you didn't do it back then, right? If you already don't have a clear folder structure with straightforward classification, you definitely should do this now. Sort the models into groups, classify them by function, and categorize and link the maps. Make sure everything has its place and it's easy to access. And the final tip. Keep the naming clear. As trivial as it sounds, this may be the most important thing you should be focusing on, as being fast starts with a great organization. Plan ahead. Think about the future. What if you need to go back to the file in a few years later? Will it be still workable? What if you hire someone? Does the folder structure still work? On top of this, keep your folders clean and make sure your file contains only necessary information. For example, delete the objects that are not visible in the camera, reflections, or shadows. This not only helps you in having more storage on your computer, but also in making your viewport less laggy and save your time. Controlling your file size should be one of the top priorities during the production process, especially if you don't have enough RAM. But also, the smaller the scene file, the faster the work in 3ds Max, as for example saving and loading are quicker. First of all, control the number of polys in your scene. You can turn on this option here in the Configure Viewports window. So you can either check how many polys and vertices the selected object have as well as the whole scene. Secondly, attach objects instead of keeping them in groups. 3ds Max handles better fewer objects. Another thing you can do is to use proxies with high poly objects. It doesn't improve rendering time, but it will make your scene file smaller and the viewport will work faster. And finally, optimize the objects or use low poly ones in places that are far from the camera. You can optimize your scene similarly by using lower resolution textures in the background. By applying these practices to your workflow, I guarantee you that you will become faster. If you want to learn all the things I do to speed up my workflow in 3ds Max, join our updated optimization training. Also, watch other videos on similar topics. Bye-bye!